So we turn, my friends, once more to matters of the heart, a word that's used so much I hardly know where to start. Yours is hungry for adventure, it's a little left of center. I'm so very grateful for your heart. Perhaps the thing I love the most is its profound compulsion to pump your blood around your body of its own propulsion, moving oxygen and energy with unfailing regularity. I'm so very grateful for your heart. So often celebrated, maybe it's overrated, and your skin keeps out the weather, and it holds you all together. And I can't help wondering whether I'm equally grateful for your skin. Now you have a beautiful heart, but other organs deserve our love too. Come, we never hear such songs about the lungs or liver. You've a fine pair of the one and an impressive example of the other. When you tell me that you love me or pour yourself a glass of whiskey, well, I'm so very grateful for your lungs and your liver. Now, when we say heart, that's just a code for something in the brain. And I want no part of that encroaching theft of word terrain. Plus, did you know without the head, you could even wind up dead? I'm so very grateful for your brain. I put this to a friend, a doctor of medicine. She said without a kidney, you'd be in trouble quickly. Turns out the body is a complex machine of highly interrelated essential systems, each composed of many unsung heroes. Now you have a beautiful heart, but other organs deserve our love. So, my friends, the time has come to recap from the start. I'm grateful for your skin, yes, grateful for your lungs and liver, grateful for your brain. Whether you're talking love or veins, I'm still so very grateful for your